channel. Avicii is no more, and really what a tribute it is. The radio stations around the world continue to play his music and will continue to do so. Last leg of conversation with Dr. Pheroza Godrej. We're approaching the 9:50 a.m. live mark.
This is Good Morning Mumbai with Hrishi K.
One other thing that the book talks about, The Secrets of Mangroves, is the fact that this mangrove cover actually absorbs carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and tons of carbon dioxide added. So let's end with that. Tell me about that.
Okay, there was almost a two-year research study which revealed quite a lot to us. You see, it's not system which is only in Vikhroli. This silent ecosystem, it's really a service which goes much beyond the boundaries of even the entire Bombay metropolitan region. And what this two-year research study revealed, that the standing stock with its biomass and its sediments holds about 6 lakh tons equivalent of carbon dioxide. That's a huge amount of carbon dioxide, a key greenhouse gas responsible for what we call today global warming and climate change. Additionally, Hrishikesh, there's about 60,000 equivalent tons of carbon dioxide which is sequestered every year. So besides land stabilization, this mangrove ecosystem plays a vital role in this natural cycle and the nutrients recycling, thereby maintaining what we call an environmental balance.
Okay, I'm just going to interrupt this and tell you guys that if you want to pick up this book, The Secrets of Mangroves by Katie Bagley, it's absolutely free. It's at mangroves.godrej.com, www.mangroves.godrej.com. If you want it for schools, get in touch on that website. There's also a mail, mangroves@godrej.com. If you want, bulk books to be sent to schools and you want to educate your children. It's a lovely, sweet little story. It doesn't even preach or anything like that. It's about this family who's marooned on an island and what happens there thereafter. Okay, I'm going to now digress. 50 years of the Cymroza Art Gallery. What a wonderful gift you've given the city. A little birdie tells me that it all started because you wanted to hold, the younger you at the time wanted to hold an exhibition and you were denied that right.
Yes, it is a bit of a digression and you've caught me on the wrong foot. But yes, it's almost approaching 50 years. Cymroza was started in 1971 on a passion. And the passion came out of deep, deep regret that there was nowhere for a young person like me who was trying to juggle arts degree and an art, fine art degree while I was growing up in my teens. I'm most grateful to my parents, especially my mother, and senior artists like Bendre and Heba, who said, no, go ahead, Sabawala, Hussein, every one of them, Akbar, who'd passed away, one of my dearest and closest friends who passed away yesterday evening in Coimbatore. They said, start an art gallery. And I said, start an art gallery. I said, will you lend me your pictures? Will you loan me your pictures to display? And each one of them, every one of them, unequivocally, including the sculptress Pilu Poch Khanawala, who fired me for designing a logo and a letterhead which was old English type. And she said, you can't have that for a modern art gallery. So in 1968-69, when I said want to have an exhibition, I've got over 100 paintings, my mother was pulling her hair out, when do we store all this, my teachers, I had two fabulous teachers, both students of the JJ School of Art, Lady Marie Temple and Mr. Gajanand Hazanis, and they were my teachers at school. And they were still living at that time, and I said, I'm going to do a show. And it was at Chetna, and I discovered years later when Chaya Arya was celebrating Chetna, that Akbar's first exhibition was also at Chetna. So obviously he was denied exhibition space at the Artist Center. There was no, the Jahangirat Gallery came up later. And so I said, okay, if you don't want to exhibit my work and I have to have an exhibition before you will even consider exhibiting me, where do I go? It is a chicken and the egg concept. Where do you go? So there was this tiny little space that my parents had. And he said, okay, you can go ahead and start your art gallery. And that's how it started. And it's always remained a gallery that is discovering young artists. And we are not young anymore. We're all going into our 70s. And it's 50 years. I was 23 years old. It required a lot of courage. But you know, when you're young, who worries about failure? You just want to go ahead and do it, and you just think very positively. So in a way, it was good that the galleries turned me down, because I grew up with people like as diverse as Aparna Kaur, Manjeet Bava, Rekha Rodwitya, Pablo Bartholomew, the photographer, Latika Kat, and the sculptress. And we, I started Cymroza, and we are going to start the celebration of Cymroza next week with what we have always promoted is the print, the lithography. When I say print, I mean lithography, etching, serigraphs, and we're going to start. And it's a whole slew of young people from around the world who've printed for us, and we're going to do this exhibition. And that's going to be the kickstart for 50 years of celebration, 5 decades, 5 sets of artists. And I've enjoyed that part of my life very much. And it has really, really brought me so many friends, a lot of heartbreak, but a lot of reward as well.
Dr. Godrej, it's been an absolute pleasure to host you on the show this morning. Thank you for all your insights, and more power to you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. We're going to do some messages. When we come back, the best of 2019 on the show.